of us have suffered at the hands of man. I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. But then, bunny tricks went out of style. So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life.
大家好，我是 Bella。想要学习地道的英语口语表达吗？那你就来对地方了。在这个频道呢，我们会通过大量的英语原声视频来学习最地道的英语口语表达。还等什么呢？赶快订阅频道吧。好了，那下面我们就开始今天的学习吧。
Us have suffered at the hands of man. See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man.
See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man. 看吧，我们全都败在人类的手中。这里的 see 它就是 you see 的意思。你看吧 ，all of us 我们所有人 have suffered 用到了 suffered 的现在完成时。Suffer 表示受苦、受难、受折磨的意思。At the hands of man, 在人类的手中。所以 have suffered at the hands of man, 就是在人类的手中受尽了折磨。
I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties.
I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. 就拿我来说吧，我曾经是魔术师，用在儿童派对上用来表演的。For instance, 它就相当于 for example, 例如的意思。所以 take me for instance, 就是拿我来举个例子吧，以我为例的意思。Magician, 魔术师 ,rabbit, 兔子野兔。I was a magician's rabbit, 我曾经是个魔术师的小兔子。这里 magician's 的 EPS 啊，它就是一个名词所有格，用来表示什么什么的，这里就是魔术师的。For kids parties, 在儿童的派对上用的。那这里我们看见的 EPS 的 一撇 放在了 S 之后，那是为什么和刚刚不一样呢？它其实啊是这样子的，在单数的情况下呢，我们需要加上 一撇 加上 S 表示谁的。那如果这个词是复数的，比如这个 kids， 它是一个复数的形式，只需要在 S 之后加上 一撇 就可以了，它就表示孩子们的。因为孩子们是一个复数嘛，所以之后的 parties 也要变成 party 的复数形式。
But then...Bunny tricks went out of style. But then, bunny tricks went out of style.
But then, bunny tricks went out of style. 但是后来，兔子的把戏不再受欢迎了。Bunny 就是小朋友、儿童说兔子会用 bunny 这个词。Trick 在这里就表示逗人开心的戏法、把戏。A card trick 纸牌戏法，所以这里 bunny tricks 就是兔子戏法。Went 是 go 的过去式，所以 go out of style 就是过时的、不再流行的意思。那过时的还可以用 get out of fashion 来表示。
So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life. So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life.
And what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life.然后我的主人做了些什么？他选择了离开、消失，接着把我从他的生命当中也变不见了。这里 left 是 leave 的过去式，那 leave something behind 就表示留下某物的意思。Disappear 就是消失、不见的意思，所以 made me disappear 就是让我变消失了。From his life 从他的生命当中。这句话当中小兔子啊用来描述他的过去的一段生活，所以呢用到的都是过去的时态。大家看见了 went, left, 还有 made 都是过去的时态。所以当我们想要用来表达描述过去的状态的时候，可别忘了要用过去的时态哦。
See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man. I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. But then...Bunny tricks went out of style. So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life.
Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. The trainees used to practice on me until they ran out of space.
I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. Ain't that right? See, monkeys.
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor.
Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. 是啊， 我曾经住在纹身店里。这里我们又看见了 live in， 它表示居住在某地。那这只小猪呢，住在 a tattoo parlor。Tattoo 就是纹身，在皮肤上刺花纹。Parlor it means a shop or a store that provides particular goods or services， 表示专营某种商品或者业务的店铺、商铺。所以合在一起 ，tattoo parlor 就是纹身店。
The trainees used to practice on me. The trainees used to practice on me.
The trainees used to practice on me. 实习生都在我身上练习。Trainee it means a person who has been taught how to do a particular job. 接受培训者、实习生、见习生。Used to practice 用到了 used to do 这个表达式啊，这个是避讳词组。它就表示过去常常做某事，过去经常习惯性的做某事，但现在可能已经不再这样做了。Practice to do an activity or train regularly so that you can improve your skill. 练习、实习、训练。On me， 在我身上。
Until they ran out of space. Until they ran out of space.
Until they ran out of space. 直到没有地方画了。可怜的小猪啊，都被画满了。Until 直到什么为止？这里的 ran 就是 run 的过去式， run out of 它又是一个固定词组搭配，它就表示用完或者耗尽了，通常指数量不足或者用完了的意思。 I need to go to the store because I've run out of milk. 我需要去商店，因为我没有牛奶了。所以原句当中的 run out of space 就表示没有空间了。
I mean yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage.I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage.
I mean, yes, humans say they love us. 我是说，人们口口声声地说爱护我们。这里我们又看见了 I mean 啊，口语当中也经常会遇到了这个口语词。我的意思是说 ，human 就是人的意思啊。But then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. 但是一转身却把我们像垃圾一样的丢掉。这句话的开头 but then 就是用来表示转折，中文可以翻译成然后却怎么样，用于演出接下来发生的不同的或者令人惊讶的事情。
She was doing well in her exams, but then she suddenly fell ill and couldn't continue.
她的考试成绩一直都不错的，然后却突然生病了，无法继续考试了。
Turn around 又是一个词组，表示翻身、转身、翻转的意思。 Turn around and let me look at your back.
转过身去让我看看你的后背。
这里 throw us out 用到了 throw somebody out， 表示赶某人出去。
Like garbage， 这里的 garbage 就表示生活的垃圾，不需要的东西，废物。所以 throw us out like garbage 就是把我们像扔垃圾一样的扔掉。
Ain't that right, sea monkeys? Ain't that right, sea monkeys?
Ain't that right, sea monkeys? 我说的对吗，海猴子？ Ain't 它就是 am not, is not, are not 的缩合，表示不是的意思，其实就是是的反义词了。Ain't that right? 这个字面翻译啊，就是那不是正确的吗？其实就是一个反问句了，就是说这是正确的，是不是？对不对 ？Sea monkey 字面翻译叫海猴子，它其实就是生活在水里的一种动物，指的是一种咸水虾。
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad. Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
长得跟广告不一样，也不是我们的错啊。
Fault 表示责任、过错、过失。It's not our fault.
这不是我们的过失，不是我们的错误。
Look like 看起来像。We don't look like
我们看起来不像。
Ad 就是 advertisement 的缩写，就是广告的意思。
We don't look like the ad. 我们看起来和广告不像。
Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. The trainees used to practice on me.Until they ran out of space.
I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. Ain't that right, sea monkeys?
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Come on! We gotta get to shore!
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well!
Swim, tiny dog, swim! Help! Max, grab the ring! I can't! Keep it up, Max! You're doing...You know, you're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something. You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke. No problem.
Finally, I'm going home. Is it home that way? Come on! We gotta get to shore!
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well.
Come on. We gotta get to shore.
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well.
Come on, we gotta get to shore. 快点儿，我们得到岸上去。I only know the doggy paddle and I don't know it well. 我只会游狗爬式呢，而且还不在行。Come on 这个词组在口语当中我们是不是经常会听到，它同样也有很多种的含义啊。在本句话当中它就表示催促对方加快速度。比如这个例句 Come on, we're running late. 快点儿，我们要迟到了。Gotta 我们说过很多遍了，这里我就简短的说一下，它就是 have got to 的口语表达式，表示必须不得不怎么样的意思。Gotta go 就是口语当中说我得走了。Duke 说 We gotta get to shore。 这里 shore 它就表示海洋、湖泊等大水域的岸边。那如果有学习金融或者经济的朋友们肯定听过 offshore 这个词组，它就表示离岸的，离岸账户就是 offshore account。 The company has set up an offshore account to avoid taxes。 公司设立了一个离岸账户用以避税。Get to the shore, 这里 get to 就表示到达某个地方或者达成某个目标。比如 I finally managed to get to the party after a long day at work. 经过一天的工作，我终于设法参加了这个派对。所以 Duke 大喊道 We gotta get to shore, 就是我们得到岸上去，得到岸边。I only know, 这里 know 大家可能都知道它的意思啊，就是知道了解。这里想要给大家扩展的一点是，如果想要表达会某项技能或者会某个语言，就可以用 know 来表示。除了知道了解，它还表示 to have learned a skill or language that be able to use it， 学会掌握的意思。比如 Do you know any Japanese？ 你会日语吗 ？Max 在水中划拉着，他说 I only know the doggy paddle。这里 doggy paddle 它就表示狗爬式。一种游泳的姿势，学过游泳的朋友们肯定都知道啊，狗爬式是我们最容易学会的一种游泳的方式，那它就是模仿了小狗狗的泳姿。所以这里 Max 说的、哦、我不会别的，我只会狗爬式。那由于这里 doggy paddle 它是一项游泳的技能，所以 Max 说的 I only know， 它用到了 know 这个动词来表达我会这个技能。所以以后大家如果想要表达会某项技能的时候，别忘了 know 这个动词哦。And I don't know it well. 我还不太在行，我只会这个还不太行，那怎么办呀？要淹死了。I don't know it well 这句话建议大家全句记住啊，这个可能我们以后会经常用到，可以放在任何的对话当中。如果想要表达说我还不太在行 ，I don't know it well.
Swim, tiny dog, swim! Help! Swim, tiny dog, swim! Help!
Swim, tiny dog, swim! 快游啊，小小狗！这里 swim 大家应该都认识，就是游泳的意思。 I can't swim， 我不会游泳。 Tiny 表示 very small in size or amount， 极小的，数量极少的。 Max 和 Duke 相比真的是一只小小狗，所以他说 Tiny dog swim， 小狗你快游。 Duke help， Duke 救我，这句话还挺管用的，如果大家最好没有，但是万一发生意外的时候就大声呼救 help。
Max grab the ringI can't! Max, grab the ring! I can't!
Max, grab the ring! Max, 抓住救生圈。 Grab 这个单词想必大家都会了，在老友记当中还记得吗？ Ross 说 grab the spoon, 抓住勺子，所以 grab 就表示迅速拿起，迅速抓取。Ring 它本意是表达环状物体，圈形的东西，圆形的东西，所以戒指我们也会用 ring 来表达 a gold ring, 金戒指。那我们看到这个救生圈也是圆形物体嘛，所以 Duke 就说 grab the ring。 想要更正式的来表达救生圈可以用 life ring。 I can't， 我做不到啊，我没办法，这句话不太难，所以呢大家都应该学会的。
Keep it up Max， you're doing well， yeah, you're not doing great， but you're not drowning and that's something。 Keep it up Max， you're doing well， yeah, you're not doing great， but you're not drowning and that's something
Keep it up, Max. You're doing well. You're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something. 撑着，你做的，做的不是那么好，但是至少你还没有被淹死，已经很了不起了。Keep it up, 坚持下去，通常用于鼓励他人保持某种状态或者行为。If you already eat in a healthy diet, keep it up. 如果你已经有了健康的饮食，那么请继续保持。You're doing, 你做的。 这里 Duke 原来还想说表扬他鼓励他一下，但是现实情况他其实做的并不怎么样，所以他说 Well, you're not doing great, 啊、你做的也没那么好。这里 well 的表达方式应该也有学到过、哦、你们还记得吗？他就表示停顿之后继续交谈。 Duke 说 you're not doing, 停顿了一下，想一下该怎么表达呢？他接着说 well, 就表示我在想，我想要怎么样说我的下一句话。 you're not doing great 之后经常会跟着一个 but, 它其实就是先抑后扬，先要说你其实并不好，但是怎么样，来鼓励你继续做下去。But you're not drowning, 这里的 drowning 它就是 drowned, 现在分词形式，那 drown 它就表示溺水，淹死的意思。Duke 说你做的不是太好，但是还没淹死， so that's something. 所以 that's something 就是一句 expression used to say that there is one thing that you should be glad about. 至少有一件事你应该高兴的，值得高兴的，那通常用来鼓励别人，表示那还不错，真是了不起。At least we have some money left, that's something, isn't it? 至少我们还留下点钱，已经不错了，是不是？
You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke. No problem.
Finally, I'm going home.
Is it home that way? You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke. No problem.
Finally, I'm going home.
Is it home that way?
You're almost there. 你快到了。我们学到了很多鼓励别人的表达式啊，这里 you're almost there 也表示你就快成功了，再加油一下。 Come on, you're almost there, 来吧，你能做到的。 Thanks, Duke, no problem. Finally, I'm going home. Isn't home that way? 谢谢你 Duke, 没事儿，终于我可以回家了。回家的路不是那个方向吗？ Max 说谢谢你 Duke,Duke 说没关系，他用到了 no problem。 以前我们可能学到 you are welcome 用来回复 thanks, 表示不用客气，没关系。那这里我们学到的 no problem 其实是比 you are welcome 更口语，更没有那么正式，没有那么礼貌一点的用法，但是在每一天的日常的口语交流当中是最常用到的一种表达方式。所以大家记住了吗？ no problem 没有关系，没事儿。Finally, it means after a long time, especially when there has been some difficulty or delay. 在很长一段时间，特别是有一些难处或者延迟的时候，你终于做了某些事。所以 finally 就是终于，最终。The performance finally started half an hour late. 晚了半个小时以后，演出终于开始了。经过一番折腾之后 ，Max 说 ：“Finally, I'm going home. 终于我要回家了。”没想到却发现一个不好的事实 ，isn't home that way? 回家的路不是那个方向吗？所以这里的 way 它就表示路线、道路的意思。To ask somebody the way， 向某人问路。
Come on, we gotta get to shore.
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well.
Swim, tiny dog, swim! Help! Max, grab the ring!I can't!
Keep it up, Max! You're doing...
Well, you know, you're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something!
You're almost there! Thanks, Duke. No problem.
Finally, I'm going home.
Is it home that way?
You know, I saw this place from the outside many times.
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke? Man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it. You know, I saw this place from the outside many times.
You know, I saw this place from the outside many times. 你知道吗？我曾经从外面见过这个地方，还见过很多次。Saw 就是 see 的过去式，看见。Saw this place 过去看见过这个地方。From the outside 从外面。Many times 很多次。
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you. Had I known what treasures awaited within these
walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
我若要是知道这里头有这么多宝藏，早就冲进来了。这句话的句型结构看起来还挺复杂的，是不是？它用到了虚拟条件句，表示与过去事实相反的一种情况。那怎么样构成这个条件句呢？稍微给大家讲一下，条件从句中的谓语动词要用到 had 加上过去分词，就是 had done。那我们这里看到了说的是 had know， 我如果知道的话。主句谓语动词要用 should、would、could、might 加上 have。再加上过去分词，那我们来看看 Duke 说的主句是不是这个结构啊？他说到 I would have broke down that door， 他用到了 would have， 就是 would have 加上 broke down。 所以 Duke 在这里想表达的是，如果过去我知道这么一个信息，那我就会采取一种行动，表示与过去事实相反的一种条件假设。我们来看一个例句吧，可能会更容易了解一点。If I'd left sooner, I'd have been on time. 要是我早点动身，我就能准时到了，就表示过去我动身迟了的意思。那第一个 I'd left sooner 这里的 I'd 它就是 I had， 条件句当中用 had done。 后一个 I'd have been on time， 这里 I'd 是 I would have been on time， 主句当中用到了 would have done 这个形式。那这个和过去事实相反的虚拟条件句大家都掌握了吗？接下来我们就来看里面的单词和词组。 What treasures awaited within these walls， 这里 treasures 就表示宝藏的意思，它是 treasure 的复数形式啊，就表示这里面有很多的宝藏。 Awaited 就是 await 的过去式，表示 to wait for somebody something， 等候等待期待。 Within these walls， 在这些墙内。I would have broke down， 这里 broke 就是 break 的过去式，那 break something down 就是一个词组表达，表示 to make something fall down, open, etc. by hitting it hard， 打倒砸破某物。 Break down that door， 砸掉那堵墙。 Firefighters had to break the door down to reach the people trapped inside， 消防员不得不破门而入，解救困在里面的人。最后我们又看到 a long time ago 也是经常会看见的词组表达式，就表示很久以前，远在过去。 A long time ago people used to communicate by sending letters， 很久以前人们还通过寄信来交流。最后 Duke 还加了一句 I'll tell ya， 这里的 ya 在上一集视频当中就学过了，它就表示 you 的意思，所以I'll tell you 在口语表达当中啊，它字面翻译就是我告诉你，但其实呢它就表示和别人分享你的观点， to share your opinion with someone。 所以这个短句可以放在一个句子的开头，也可以放在结尾，比如 I'll tell you that was the best sushi I've ever had in my life， 我告诉你那是我这辈子吃过最好吃的寿司。
What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
DukeMan, wait, did you used to have an owner? What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
What are you talking about? 你在说什么？这句话我想不用多做解释了吧，我们应该学过很多次了，在口语当中呢也经常会用到。当别人说的一段话你不太理解或者是觉得很疑惑的时候，可以反问到 What are you talking about? 你到底在说什么呀？
My old owner and I used to live around here.
我和我之前的主人就住在这附近。
Old owner 这里的 old 可不再表示老的意思啊，它表示过去的、从前的意思。
比如这个例句 Things were different in the old days. 从前的情况可不一样。
Live around 就表示居住在附近。 Many of my friends live around the university.
我的很多朋友都住在大学附近。
Live around here, 住在这附近。
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Duke, 慢着，你曾经有过主人。
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it.
那是很久以前的事儿了，我不太想说。 这两句话建议大家全句记住，每个单词都很简单，但却是口语当中很常见的表达。那当然，如果更口语一点的话，大家可以把 want to 改成 wanna。 所以在以后你们的对话当中，想要表达这是很久以前的事了，我不想说，就是 It was a long time ago, I don't wanna talk about it.
You know, I saw this place from the outside many timesHad I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke? Man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know. But you know what?He was so cool. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know. But you know what? He was so cool.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know.But you know what? He was so cool.
Yes, you do. Come on. I don't know. But you know what? He was so cool. 你想说的，拜托。我不是很确定。但是你知道吗？他好酷的。这里 Max 说到的 Yes, you do, 它就是和上一句当中的 I don't 来进行一个衔接。Duke 说 I don't, 我不想。Max 说 Yes, you do, 你想。那如果 Duke 依然坚持说他不想，他可以这样说 No, I don't, 我就是不想。但是呢 Duke 有一点委婉，他说 I don't know, 我也不是很清楚了，不知道我是怎么想的。接着 Duke 说 But you know what, 你知道吗？这句话就是用来表示强调， To emphasize a point, 想要强调他接下来所说的内容。比如用在这个例句当中， I know it's a lot of work, But you know what, it'll be worth it in the end.我知道有很多的事需要做了，但是你知道吗？到最后一定会是值得的。He was so cool. 他是一个特别好的人，特别酷的人。
And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks.
Man, we had fun. 天哪，我们过着很有趣的生活。We'd play fetch.我们会一起玩游戏。We'd go for walks. 我们一起散步。Man, we had fun. 这里的 man 它其实是一个 exclamation used to express surprise, anger, 表示你的情绪。哦，天哪，这个意思。Man, that was great. 哇，太棒了。Had 是 have 的过去式，那 have fun 就表示玩得很开心。那 we had fun 就表示我们过得很开心。Had fun, 它更指有一些娱乐活动这样的愉快的生活。就像 Duke 接下来说到 We'd play fetch, 我们会一起玩扔飞盘游戏。Fetch, 它其实表示去拿来的意思，表示两个动作，先去，然后拿回来。所以呢，就是小狗狗扔飞盘的游戏。狗狗们需要追出去，再把飞盘咬回来，所以就是 fetch. She's gone to fetch the kids from school.他去学校接孩子了，就是有两个动作，他要去学校，然后再把孩子带回家。Go for walks, go for a walk 就表示散步的意思。Let's go for a walk, 咱们去散步吧。
We'd take naps. We're both big nappers. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers.
We'd take naps. We were both big nappers. 还一起睡午觉。我们都爱睡午觉呢。Nap 就是日间的小睡，打盹儿。Take naps 或者 take a nap 就表示睡午觉，小睡一下。We were both, 我们都是，这里的 were 它用到了过去的时态哦，因为是在过去发生的事情嘛。Big nappers, 这里的 napper 就来自于 nap 这个动词，打盹的人的意思。
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know.But you know what? He was so cool. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers. I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. By the time I had caught up with it and ate it...
Probably a butterfly then.
I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. A few days later, I was picked up by animal control. I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up.
I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. 我有一天跑出去追蝴蝶或者车子。Got out 这里 got 它就是 get 的过去式，那 get out 在这里就相当于 leave 离开某地。One night 有一天晚上 ，chasing 就来自于动词 chase 追赶追逐的意思。My dog likes chasing rabbits. 我的狗喜欢追捕兔子。那这里可能会有朋友们要问，为什么 chase 要用 chasing 现在分词的形式呢？它也不是表示现在进行的动作啊。其实啊，这里的现在分词的形式是做伴随状语或者方式状语来用的。就比如这个例句当中会用到的 ，He sat by the roadside begging. 他坐在路边乞讨。Butterfly 蝴蝶 ，chase butterfly 追蝴蝶。
By the time I had caught up with it and ate it,
probably a butterfly then.
By the time I had caught up with it and ate it,
probably a butterfly then.
By the time I had caught up with it and ate it, probably a butterfly then. 当我追到并且吃下去以后，那就是追蝴蝶吧。By the time 就相当于 at the time, when, 在什么的时候。那 caught 就是 catch 的过去分词， catch 在这里表示逮住、捕捉、捕获。原句当中说 catch up with it 用到了 catch up with somebody 这个表达式，赶上追上某人的意思。就像这个例句当中用到的 go on ahead I'll catch up with you， 你先走着，我随后赶上你。 ate it 这里 ate 就是 eat 的过去式，我过去追到了他，然后我吃掉了他。因为刚刚 Doug 说他不知道是在追蝴蝶还是在追车，那因为车子不能被吃嘛，所以 Max 说 probably butterfly then， 那应该就是追蝴蝶吧。
I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it.
I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. 我才发现自己离家已经很远了，我找不到回家的路了。I realized 也是口语当中我们经常会听到的表达。Realize 这里就表示我意识到了什么。在老友记当中我们也学到过这个单词。Far away from 离某地很远，离某处很远。这里 far away from my home 就是说离我家很远。
A few days later, I was picked up by animal control. A few days later, I was picked up by animal control.
A few days later, I was picked up by animal control. 几天之后呢，我就被送到了狗狗拘留所。A few days later, 在之前的视频当中，我们学过一模一样的表达，还记得吗？就表示几天之后。Pick up 在这里啊，它就表示 to arrest somebody 逮捕、追捕的意思。比如这个例句啊 ，He was picked up by police and taken to the station for questioning。警察把他抓到局子里问话去了。原句当中 was picked up 就是 pick up 的被动时态，就表示被逮捕、被抓捕。Animal control 它就是啊一个政府的行政部门，就是专门负责处理流浪动物的地方。The city's animal control department is responsible for handling stray animals. 城市的动物控制部门负责处理流浪动物。
I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up. I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up.
I had a great thing going, but I had to go and mess it up. 我之前过得很好哦，但却被我搞砸了。Have a great thing going 或者说成 have a good thing going 就表示 to have or be doing something that is successful， 很成功的在做一些事情。比如这个例句 They've got a good thing going with that little shop of theirs， 他们的商店开得挺成功的。 Mess it up 用到了 mess something up， 表示弄脏、弄乱、搞砸某件事情。 I hope you don't mess it up this time， 我希望你这次别把它搞砸了。
I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. by the time I had caught up with it and ate it...
Probably a butterfly then.
I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. A few days later, I was picked up by animal control. I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up.
See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man. I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. But then, bunny tricks went out of style. See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man. I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. But then, bunny tricks went out of style. See, all of us have suffered at the hands of man. I mean, take me for instance. I was a magician's rabbit for kids' parties. But then, bunny tricks went out of style.
So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life. So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life. So what did my owner do? My owner went and left magic behind and made me disappear from his life.
Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. The trainees used to practice on me until they ran out of space. Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. The trainees used to practice on me until they ran out of space. Uh-huh. I lived in a tattoo parlor. The trainees used to practice on me until they ran out of space.
I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. I mean, yes, humans say they love us, but then they turn around and throw us out like garbage. Ain't that right, sea monkeys?
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Ain't that right, sea monkeys?
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Ain't that right, sea monkeys?
Hey, it's not our fault we don't look like the ad.
Come on! We gotta get to shore!
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well!
Swim, tiny dog, swim!
Come on! We gotta get to shore!
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well!
Swim, tiny dog, swim!
Come on! We gotta get to shore!
I only know the doggy paddle, and I don't know it well!
Swim, tiny dog, swim!
Help!
Max, grab the ring!
I can't!
Keep it up, Max! You're doing... Well, you know, you're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something!
Help!
Max, grab the ring!
I can't!
Keep it up, Max! You're doing... Well, you know, you're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something!
Help!
Max, grab the ring!
I can't!
Keep it up, Max! You're doing... Well, you know, you're not doing great, but you're not drowning, and that's something!
You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke.
No problem.
Finally. I'm going home.
Is it home that way?
You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke.
No problem.
Finally. I'm going home.
Is it home that way?
You're almost there!
Thanks, Duke.
No problem.
Finally. I'm going home.
Is it home that way?
You know, I saw this place from the outside many times. You know, I saw this place from the outside many times. You know, I saw this place from the outside many times.
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
Had I known what treasures awaited within these walls, I would have broke down that door a long time ago, I'll tell you.
What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner? What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner? What are you talking about?
My old owner and I used to live around here.
Duke, man, wait, did you used to have an owner?
Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it. Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it. Well, it was a long time ago. I don't want to talk about it.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know. But you know what? He was so cool.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know.
But you know what? He was so cool.
Yes, you do. Come on.
I don't know. But you know what? He was so cool. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers. And we had fun. We'd play fetch. We'd go for walks. We'd take naps. We're both big nappers.
I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. By the time I had caught up with it and ate it...
Probably a butterfly then.
I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. By the time I had caught up with it and ate it...
Probably a butterfly then.
I got out one night chasing a butterfly or a car. By the time I had caught up with it and ate it...
Probably a butterfly then.
I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. I realized I was so far away from my home, I couldn't find it. A few days later, I was picked up by animal control.
I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up.
A few days later, I was picked up by animal control.
I had a great thing going. I had to go and mess it up.
好了，那今天的视频学习片段就先到这里。如果你还想要跟着大量的英语原声视频来学习最地道的英语口语表达的话，记得关注频道、点赞加分享。那我们下期视频再见喽，拜拜。